One minute she is a super sexy spy, the next she is a serial killer. Is there anything Yvonne Strahovski can't do? We're going to meet her in a second, but first, here is her story.
After moving to LA 7 years ago, Yvonne Strahovski has done nothing but impress.
Okay, which one? This one or the leopard print?
From super sexy spy Sarah Walker in Chuck to serial killer Hannah McKay in Dexter.
You think I'm bad?
She also starred in Australian film, I Love You Too.
I've never once said that you love me.
Now, this Aussie beauty is kicking butt as CIA agent Kate Morgan, opposite Kiefer Sutherland in 24, Live Another Day.
And she's here in the studio with us. It's Yvonne Strahovski, everyone. Yeah. Take a moment.
Good morning.
Welcome home. If you had to decide, you know, if you had to choose between playing a super sexy spy and a serial killer, which one is more fun?
Look, they're both fun.
You were a super sexy serial killer as well, I must say.
Well, thank you. Yes, there was a lot of bikini footage. Yeah. If I'd known that, you know, I might have prepped a little more when I did the scene. You know, they're both fun. I've played a spy now twice for two shows. So the serial killer thing was a nice bonus because I'd never done that before.
Yeah, because you worked a song alongside Kiefer Sutherland in 24. What was that like?
Yeah, it was really good. I found it to be surprisingly really sort of collaborative because I thought being on such a well-oiled show that had been on for 8 years that, you know, it would be kind of rigid, but it wasn't. It was really collaborative and Kiefer was great to work with. And the most admirable thing for me to watch was that he was not only invested as an actor, you know, being Jack Bauer, and he's so good at that role, but he's also very much invested as an executive producer of the show. And really, you know, looks at it as an overall project.
You look like you'd have a... It's quite physically demanding. Is it tough?
It's a little tough, but it's not anything I'm not used to. You know, I've done jobs now where I've been involved in a lot of stunt work, sure. So I kind of fell into it. I mean, there was one more demanding scene, the torture scene, where I was strung up sort of this way on a rope and chain, and that was, you know, I was a little sore after that.
Yeah, I've got one of those swings at my house. But...
Wow. It is exhausting watching 24 because it's so full-on. Is it that full-on filming it?
It is. I would say filming it is very similar to the experience of watching it, especially when we're working with John Cassar. He's one of the directors that's been with the show for a really long time, and he keeps the pace going, and it's great for us as actors because it really feeds the energy, you know, that we need to have the scenes.
Is there a big clock on set counting down?
Sorry, is this where you see your career, like an action woman?
No, not really. I think I've been lucky to have played diverse roles, but I'm most known for the ones where I'm the action girl. But there's been, like, the serial killer was great, or I got to do my Broadway debut a year and a half ago, which was a totally different character as well. But so I like to branch out and sort of touch on different
genres. Which do you prefer, theatre or movies?
Theatre's probably where my heart is because I grew up in theatre, but I love doing camera work as well. I love both.
But what about computer games like Mass Effect?
Do you know, I've never played it.
Really?
No, which I should because...
I'm a big fan of Mass Effect.
Oh, you are? Yeah, okay. Miranda?
Miranda. the perfect girl.
Oh, right, yes. No, that was fun. That's great work doing the voiceover stuff. Yeah.
So now you call LA home. Are you part of the Gumleaf Mafia that's sort of operating over there at the moment? Because it's really nice that all the Aussies get together and look after each other.
They do. They really do. I feel like I'm not in town often enough to sort of connect with them because, you know, when we shot 24, we were living in London for half a year and I'm off again somewhere. So, you know, I'm never there long enough. Plus, I'm a bit of a recluse now that I've moved to Malibu and I spend a lot of time at the beach because I just started surfing a year ago.
Oh, wow. Isn't it really cold in the water off Malibu? Like freezing?
We wear wetsuits, yeah. So it is cold.
You're talking about Yvonne Strahovski here.
Yeah, true.
You mentioned you were off again. You got another role in Sun?
There's something coming up that I just can't talk about just yet. But there is a film later on in the year that I'll be doing with Adrian Brody called Manhattan Nocturne. So that's something I'm looking forward to as well.
Mm-hmm. Is it nice to be home?
It's great to be home. I wish I could be home for longer. My folks are here and it's great to spend time
with
them.
Yeah, go with them. Is this your family in the front?
That's my mum and dad.
There they are. Strahovski. Hey, guys.
Aw, your lovely fan club.
That is so lovely. And you know what? It obviously goes to show that you've had this amazing family that supported you and your career. So, you know, helping you get to where you've got to.
Yeah, mum and dad have always been there for me ever since. Mum was chasing me around the house with a video camera when I was a kid, you know, when I was goofing around in front of the camera. So, yeah, she's been the camera woman from day one.
Oh. You can see you've got your mum.
Well, they must be very, very proud. What a great chick you are, Yvonne. Thank you very much for joining us on the studio. And good news, you can watch Yvonne anytime you like. 24 Live Another Day is available on Blu-ray and DVD from next Tuesday. Thanks.